A lot of people will ask me, well, how come you don't talk about healing? You know, that God can heal you from sexual damage. Well, I believe God can heal anybody from anything. I've no problem with that. But I think sometimes we're a little bit too quick to just tell people, don't worry, you know, you shouldn't do that, but it'll be okay. God will heal you. Not everybody gets healed. And it's a cavalier attitude that's not healthy. It's like me saying to my children, you shouldn't play on the roof, but if you do play on the roof and you fall off and break all your arms and legs, that's okay, God will heal you. Well, you'd never think like that. But yeah, that's the way the church acts. Yeah, you shouldn't have sex before marriage, and I know you can have damage, but don't worry, God can heal you. For some people, yeah, they might just instantly get healed. Their arms and legs will get all straightened out right away. A lot of people will wind up having to go through a lot of painful surgery from breaking all their arms and legs. Some people might struggle to walk because when they were kids, they kept falling off the roof and breaking their legs. That's the reality of life. So I am all for healing. According to your faith, let it be done unto you. God can do wonderful things of healing in your heart and in your life. But you know, the reality is not everybody gets that kind of a miracle. And let me add this as well. It's interesting that the Bible talks about human beings being made up of three parts, just like God is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We too have a body, we have a soul, our mind, our intellect, and then we have a spirit. Our spirit is instantly changed when we come to a place of faith. That's why it's referred to as being born again. It's like something happens to you. Physically, God can touch and transform you and do miracles in you physically, as I just mentioned. But you know, it's interesting when it comes to the mind, Paul encourages the Christians. He says, you need to be transformed in your mind. Well, how, Paul? How do I do that? Just lay hands on me and God's going to instantly change the way I think? No, he says you need to be transformed by the renewing of your mind. You need to change the way you think. And it's interesting that a lot of the sexual damage that I'm talking about isn't really physical damage. I mean, sometimes there is. That's really the easy healing. It's the soul, it's the mental part of our heads. And the Bible doesn't talk a whole lot about instant healing in your head. It talks about you changing the way you think, being renewed deliberately and intentionally. And that's what I'm talking to couples about. Those who've struggled in this area because of damage that they picked up before they got married, because they got involved in sexual things before, a lot of it's all here. And there is no presto change-o solution to that. You need to change the way you think. And just starting with the fact that you need to understand that it's not going to be easy, you're going to have to work on it. To get to where you want is what I'm trying to do for couples.